Good evening, everybody. I'm Dr. Kristen Porter Utley, and I'm the Vice President for Academic Affairs and Provost here at Framingham State University. It's wonderful to have you here for here today for the university's 2024 graduate commencement ceremony. If you're not already standing and are able, please rise for the national anthem sung by our very own Caitlin Hallig, a member of the class of 2025.
Testing?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed that the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and
you may be seated. Thank you so much, Caitlin. We'd now like to take a moment to recognize all of the veterans and current members of the military in the audience. So would you please stand if you're currently serving? Thank you so much. Thank you. Our graduate students represent a truly tremendous collection of brain power, talent, and perseverance. They have worked incredibly hard to make it here, balancing the demands of their classwork with demands on family, full-time family responsibilities, full-time jobs. And now all of those nights of frantic dinners and little sleep have paid off. I welcome all family members and friends of those about to graduate whose support and encouragement have greatly contributed to their success. I also want to extend a very warm welcome to the many faculty members who are here today who've shared their knowledge, time, and expertise with our students to help them make this day possible. A special thank you to the graduate and continuing education staff for supporting our students throughout their education and for helping to make today's celebration a true success. It's now my great pleasure to introduce Dr. Nancy S. Neamey, President of Framingham State University.
Hello, everyone. Welcome. It's really good to see you this evening. Welcome to the parents, the family, and friends who are about to graduate. Welcome, dedicated faculty, trustees, and alumni, and honored guests. I'm waiting for my teleprompter. This is a new piece of technology we're working on, so bear with us. Oh, I think we get started now. Most importantly, welcome graduates, and congratulations. To begin the ceremony, I would like everyone to join me in a brief moment of silent reflection to give thanks for everything you have accomplished, for the support and guidance of family, friends, faculty and staff, and to honor those who are no longer here. Thank you. We celebrate today your learning and the investments of time, finances, and energy while sacrificing others in order to develop a body of knowledge, perspectives, and skills that will allow you to go further in the direction of your dreams. Your master's degree builds on your prior learning and comes, for many of us, after you've spent some time in the real world. Our younger selves enter jobs, we have families, and we try to figure out just what we're doing with this degree we've earned. Even if one goes straight from a bachelor's degree program to a master's degree, either separately or through a 4+1 or 3+2, you're figuring out if that prior learning has made sense in your current program. And even if you need a master's degree to continue, to keep your job or to continue as part of required professional development, you had to have decided that you wanted to stay in the profession you started with in the first place. Sometimes your master's degree can tell you different things than you thought you would learn. Good learning is like that. In my own master's degree program, which I entered in New York State so I could keep my professional teaching licenses, I took a course in American architecture that I use virtually every day many years later just to identify the built environment around me. In that program, I also tasted kiwi for the first time. And I directed a play, the only time in my life, an experience so profound that the publicity poster from that play hangs in my home even now, reminding me of the power of that experience. And while I did not take a course in becoming a president, I know that the learning I gained in my master's degree, and in fact, in all my degrees, contributed to the person who's standing here before you in these lovely Renaissance robes we're all wearing. So, assuming that your decision to carry on with your education via learning makes sense to you, you have the privilege of being able to connect what you learned to your master's program with your prior academic, professional, and personal experiences and knowledge. You have scaffolding on which to build. I hope, that you had aha moments during your master's program when you realized the elegance of a decision-making process that happened while you were at work, or the opposite, when you realized something didn't work. You might also have understood something that you learned much more deeply than you did as an undergrad, or maybe for the very first time. You might have finally seen that your mom or your dad, or maybe your son or your daughter, was actually right about something all along. If they were, tell them later. A reading assignment in a grad school course might so deeply connect to something in your life that you simultaneously laughed and cried at the same time when you read the truth of it. You might guess that such things happened to me when I was in grad school. This degree also connects to your future. You are hopefully much more certain now about where you want this learning to go. Your analytical and communication skills are now likely well honed, and your understanding of people and the ways in which we work together successfully are likely much deeper. And now, while you will be Masters of Arts, of Business Administration, of Healthcare Administration, of Public Administration, of Science, and of Science and Nursing, your pursuit of this degree demonstrates a commitment to fostering lifelong learning for yourself and for others. You are much more able to help yourself as well as those around you, which to me is one of the responsibilities of this degree. We know that learning is not a solitary endeavor. Learning is always co-created through interactions and texts, through teachers, experiences, and reflection. It is one of the most powerful things that humans can do, and you all, have done it over and over again in pursuit of something greater to impact our world. The accomplishments which all of you claim today are the product of some very significant collaborations, especially with your faculty, your family, and friends. So graduates, I ask you, will you please rise and give a gesture of thanks to faculty and staff and to your families and all the significant people who have helped you achieve this moment. Thank you. And now, to bring greetings on behalf of the Framingham State University Board of Trustees, please welcome Chair Beth Cassavant.
I am not going to take my chances with a teleprompter. Thank you, President Nimi. It's a great honor to represent the entire Board of Trustees and congratulate today's graduates. We know that you have worked very hard to earn your degree, and you should be very proud of this accomplishment. All of us on the Board of Trustees are from the regional business and professional community and are dedicated to advancing the vast opportunities offered by the university to our students. We assist President Nimi and her leadership team to strategically improve, develop, and strengthen Framingham State University. Providing the best possible level of education and campus experience to our students is our highest priority. The trustees and President Nimi have made and will continue to make decisions to move the FSU campus forward based upon the confidence we have in the future of this university and its students and graduates. With the incredible faculty and staff here at Framingham State and all the new strategic initiatives that have been and will be undertaken, we should all be optimistic about the future of this fine university. Graduates, I hope that you will take the time to reflect on all you have accomplished these past few years. You should be confident that you are well prepared for the challenges and opportunities that await you. On behalf of all the trustees, congratulations and good luck as you move into the next phase of your lives.
Thank you, Trustee Cassavant. At this time, it is my great honor to introduce our commencement speakers, Allison and Ryan McKean, members of FSU's class of 2001. Both Allison and Ryan, after leaving Framingham State, went on to earn their law degrees from Western New England University School of Law. Allison's journey as an attorney began at one of Connecticut's leading law firms. From there, she served as counsel to the Connecticut General Assembly before joining Ryan to found the law firm that would become the Connecticut Trial Firm. Allison's leadership as Chief Operating Officer steered Connecticut Trial Firm to become the 10th fastest growing law firm in the nation. She is also a prolific writer, having published 9 novels to date. Ryan's legal career is also marked by remarkable achievements, notably securing a record-setting $100 million jury verdict for a paralyzed client in 2022. His commitment to justice has touched thousands of lives, earning him the esteemed recognition as a James Cooper Bar Fellow in 2024. As CEO of Connecticut Trial Firm, Ryan's visionary leadership has propelled the firm onto the prestigious Inc. 5000 list twice, alongside two Best Place to Work accolades from the Hartford Business Journal. He is also the acclaimed author of two best-selling books for legal professionals. Allison and Ryan demonstrate a Framingham State degree can be the foundation and wings for extraordinary lives. We are honored and grateful to have them back on campus today to give our graduate commencement address.
We decided age before beauty, so I get to go first. Thank you, President Nehme, trustees, faculty, staff, and graduates. It is an honor to be with you here today, celebrating Framingham State University's graduate class of 2024. You are a class of helpers, teachers, nurses, nutritionists, counselors. In a time of hurt, you have chosen to be healers and mentors, and I'm grateful for you. And now comes change. You're setting out on a new phase of your career, maybe your life. Some of you know exactly where you're going. Others aren't as sure. And to those of you who aren't sure, I say, same. I confess I lost sleep about writing this address because my professional life began to unravel as soon as I agreed. You see, I'm exiting the law firm I've built for the better part of a decade. And even though this is a positive change, I don't know exactly what comes next. I want to inspire you and give you some wisdom to set you on your journey, but I'm also feeling a little lost. It would be disingenuous to pretend otherwise. But in a way, it's perfect for our paths to cross right now. Life is a series of beginnings and endings, and change is constant. Today, you're ending one cycle, your graduate education, and beginning another. You may be feeling both grief and optimism, amazement at what you've accomplished, and sadness that the riot is over. Maybe you're feeling pure joy. Whatever you're feeling, I hope you take the time to sit alone and honor it. Because I'm not certain what life is about, but I think it's about embracing this human experience with its ups and downs and sideways movements. Being a parent taught me that big feelings are normal. Sometimes little humans experience big feelings about the direction in which their toast is sliced, or they become enraged if the chocolate cake is gone. And we can laugh, but come to think of it, I get mad when the chocolate cake is gone too. I've just learned that being openly angry about dessert is not socially acceptable. But it should be okay to be honest about how frightening change and uncertainty can be. You can sometimes feel this disruption in your body, as real as any bruise. It's often compared to metamorphosis, the process of being physically melted and reconstructed. That hurts. And if we don't acknowledge that fact, we imply something is wrong with it. In truth, this comes with being human. One of my favorite quotes is from Joseph Campbell, who wrote, "If you can see your path laid out in front of you step by step, you know it's not your path. Your own path you make with every step you take. That's why it's your path." This journey we're on is challenging and uncertain. Endings will take us by surprise, and beginnings will feel elusive. Sometimes we don't know where to put our foot. We often walk in the dark, trusting that the morning will come if we can just hold on. But remember, you're never actually alone. We may walk our own paths, but we are walking in the same place. I recently saw a post on social media from someone stating he was desperate to work and afraid of how his bills were piling up due to being unemployed. He received an outpouring of support through comments and shares from strangers. That's because there are people like yourselves in this world who rush in to help when they see that someone needs them. When you're the kind of person who cares for others the way you do, it can feel like you need to be strong all the time. I hope you never forget that as much as you will support others, we also want to support you. So when you're stumbling, consider leaning on the people who have held you up as you walked along this particular path. Throughout all of the sacrifice and long hours of your education, someone has cheered you on. They are precious, and they are the key to keeping perspective. I say perspective because this too shall pass. What if it's better than you could have ever imagined? The metamorphosis will be complete, and you will emerge as your new self, stronger and wiser for this challenge. Any moment, good or bad, is fleeting, and the next one will be along soon. But this moment we're in right now, being together to celebrate you, is wonderful. Your future is bright, and you have earned it. And I wish you all health, happiness, and success as you set off on the next stage of your journey.
I just yield my time. You could have 5 more minutes, Allison. Thank you, President Nimi, trustees, staff, graduates. What an honor to share this evening with you. When this university was founded in 1839, Cyrus Peirce closed each of his lessons at what was then the normal school with the phrase, "Live to the truth." When I was a student here, I never gave much thought to the motto, "Live to the truth." They were words that sounded nice, but as I've grown older, I've come to understand that phrase as the ultimate challenge for a life well lived. The truth was that when I first walked on this beautiful campus for orientation, nearly 26 years ago to the day, like so many of you today, I wanted to be a teacher. I wanted to live my life in service to others. But this life, an amazing university, changed me. I discovered through spending a lot of time doing student government at the campus center that working in government excited me. As I thought about my life and what I wanted to do with it, law school drew me in. Many lawyers work in government. When I got to law school, I discovered that I really didn't like the government. And what I really wanted to do was be a trial lawyer that helped people against the powerful. When I got out of law school for over 6 years, I did just that, working as an associate at a law firm. But the truth was, that work alone didn't fulfill me. There was something more inside of me waiting to be unlocked. I decided to leave my firm, and leaving my firm was painful. So, in 2012, with student loans, a child in daycare, a mortgage, and $2,500, I quit my job to start a law firm. I wanted to build a modern firm that leveraged technology while helping people. A year into that, I was out of my firm. That truth was painful. My partners and I had very different visions for what we wanted with our practice. So, I started anew as a solo. I decided that I wanted to get really great at trying cases. Over time, my scrappy solo practice grew into Connecticut Trial Firm. I started to become less interested in trying cases and more interested in growing and leading a law firm. As a trial lawyer, I could help a few people. Running a firm of trial lawyers allowed me to help many people. And I succeeded at this. We grew from a team of 3 to a team of 40. We've been twice honored by the Inc. 5000 as one of the fastest growing private companies in the country, and we will be for the 3rd time this year. I went from 0 to CEO. In 2022, we obtained the highest jury verdict in state history in the amount of $100 million. We had success beyond what I could have ever have imagined. And today is my last day at Connecticut Trial Firm. Like you, I'm graduating. The truth is that I stopped feeling fulfilled by it. The burdens, instead of exciting me, weighed me down. Leaving Connecticut Trial Firm was a very painful process. So I acknowledge that truth and am moving on to new ventures that fill my soul with joy. And coming full circle, part of my truth is that I want to teach. This fall, I will be an adjunct professor at University of Connecticut School of Law, and next spring at Yale Law. And I'm starting a company to teach lawyers around the country. Each time that I have lived to a truth, often a truth that I had ignored for a long period of time, I grew into the person that I was meant to be. That abundance in my career, the abundance in my career in life grew as well. You are a class of helpers, teachers, nutritionists, nurses, therapists, educators. As you leave this beautiful campus, I encourage you to live to the truth, to live to your truth. The world needs more helpers. When something isn't working, be honest with yourself and others. The space between who we are and where we want to be is often uncomfortable. Not everyone in life is going to like your decisions. In so many ways, living in someone else's truth or the truth of our past selves is more comfortable. When you live to the truth, you are constantly being reborn. Having been present for the birth of my children, being born is hard work for all involved. Know that you aren't starting over. You are starting from experience. You are amongst the most educated people in the world. You have received an education of the highest caliber from an amazing university. Whatever it is, you can do it. There is no shortage of challenges in this world that we need help with, and solving them starts within. It starts with you living to the truth, your truth. Living to the truth is the only way, in my experience, to find happiness, fulfillment, and to live life to the fullest. I wish you the best, and in the words of Cyrus Peirce, live to the truth.
Thank you so much, Allison and Ryan. Those were fantastic words. We've now reached the point in the program when we will officially award the degrees. Yay! President Nimi will certify the degrees, and they will be conferred by Trustee Beth Cassavant. Will all students receiving master's degrees please stand?
Trustee Cassavant, it is an honor to present the candidates for the degree of Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, Master of Education, Master of Healthcare Administration, Master of Human Resources, Master of Public Administration, Master of Science, or Master of Science in Nursing at Framingham State University for the conferral of their degrees. These individuals have met the appropriate requirements for the degree programs as prescribed by the faculty and the registrar, and they are entitled to all the rights and privileges thereunto appertaining.
By the authority vested in me by the Massachusetts Department of Higher Education and the Board of Trustees at Framingham State University, I hereby confer upon you the appropriate master's degree and enter you into all its attendant rights and privileges. Congratulations.
Congratulations, everyone. It's now time for the hooding ceremony. Our Dean of the Graduate and Continuing Education, our Dean of Graduate and Continuing Education, Marilyn Cleary, will assist our graduate program coordinators and advisors in hooding each graduate. Please note that a professional photographer will take pictures of each graduate. We request that the audience members remain in their seats so as to not obstruct the views of other guests. Here we go. Thank you. Ready?
Presenting the Framingham State University Master's Degree Candidates from the College of Arts and Humanities. Receiving the Master of Arts degree, concentration in English, Shannon McNutt.
From the College of Business, receiving the Master of Business Administration degree, concentration in biotechnology operations, Minerva Flor Botello. Priya Sharma. Receiving the Master of Business Administration degree, concentration in management, Sadina Issa Nadoy.
Christopher Devin Jenkins, Jr. Tiana Powell Hughes. Stephen Paul Zembruski, Jr. Receiving the Master of Healthcare Administration degree, concentration in healthcare administration, April Patricia Adams. Christopher Calix. Yeah. Maurice N. Dow. Carrie Elizabeth Dunphy. Yeah. Basma Hassanin. Patience Kobuganzi. Megan Tarantino. Joseph Shango Wanya. Receiving the Master of Human Resources degree, concentration in Human Resource Management. Joshua Allen Bolduck. Mara Catherine McGarrigle. Alicia Stankowski. Catherine Mary Van Name. Receiving the Master of Science degree, concentration in organizational leadership. Kristen Marie Corey. Lintilla Harper. Malik Isaiah Martin. Samir Z. Miyawi.
Julia Jane Sanborn.
From the College of Education and Social and Behavioral Sciences. Receiving the Master of Arts degree, concentration in counseling psychology. Regan Miles Carmody. Laura Elizabeth Sorelli. Olivia Grace Cole. Laura Alma Erickson. Jared Frank Evelyn. Joy Elise Gilman. Amber Christine Hebb. Gigi Lisa Howell. Yvette Marianne Lawhorn. Danielle Kayla Magno. Miriam Masood Mahmood. Jennifer Sanchez Sierra. Stephanie Marie Tesserero. Gabrielle Valera Vaza. Tamika Annette Young. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in early childhood education. Bridget Mary Lombardi. Catherine Margaret Moyle. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in early childhood education, specialization in initial licensure. Olivia L. Pimental. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in educational technology. Catherine Kelly Balanek. Stephanie Sarah Falasia. Kelly Morgan Guitar. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in elementary education. Ashley Veras. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in elementary education, specialization in initial licensure. Victoria Elaine Rutigliano. Kirsty Louise Vitarelli. Lauren Elizabeth Vocatura. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in international teaching.
Corinne Mayanama.
Celeste Hayden Brown. Nicholas Neil Hendy. Christy Lynn.
Maria Carlotta Ramirez Simeon.
receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in literacy and language. Danielle Yvonne Iusolano. Catherine Loredana Lorenzi. Yay! Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in nutrition education, specialization in nutrition education specialist. Noor Nidal Alajous. Kelly A. Bryant. Megan Lynn Hammes. Wendy Wingyan Ng. Desiree Okendo. Melissa Buse Palabiak. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in secondary education, specialization in art. Lindsay Marion Richard. Angela Elizabeth Watton. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in special education. Mary Elizabeth Anzwategi. Rachel Christina Buck. Brianna Ann Capone. Jennifer Yi Chan. Anna Elizabeth Christensen. Olivia Rose Dolitka. Alexandra Talia Dominguez. Eleni Giannacchi. Erin Marie Toomey. Receiving the Master of Education degree, concentration in teaching English as a second language. Taylor Lane Federico Grome. Alexandra P. Gauz. Receiving the Master of Public Administration degree, concentration in public administration. Cassandra Marie Kaklis. Liana Marie Lynch.
From the College of Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics. Receiving the Master of Science degree, concentration in food and nutrition, with the specialization in coordinated program in dietetics. Danielle Renee Bond. Nicole Soledad Brooks. Victoria Cepolia. Lais Pellens Dennis. Isabella May Mikhail Ferretti. Rebecca E. Hansen. Claire Marie Hickling. Isabel Catherine McDonald. Tara Murphy. Ilana Rose Patty. Abigail Kelly Webb. Receiving the Master of Science in Nursing degree, concentration in nursing education. Elizabeth A. Collado. Stephen Emery Dexter. Jacqueline Dion Holloway. Dorothy Sachs Hunter. Julia Ruth Cahart. Julie Ann Michaels. Vicki A. Rossillo. Alina Sorokina. Receiving the Master of Science in Nursing degree, concentration in nursing leadership. Michelle Irene Adamick. Lauren Wolf, IAO. Christina Marie Alexander.
Teresa De Mateo Blas.
Stephanie Felix. Sarah Lynn Griffin. Carla Guadalupe Haney. Lori Kellogg. Christy Lee Raymer. Meredith C. Saloni. Nicole Virginia Semenza. Marissa Leanne Troy. Erin Michelle Tully. Amelia Isabel Wool. Receiving the Professional Science Master's degree, concentration in biotechnology with the specialization in quality assurance. Natasha Gambarov.
Monira Catone. Frederick Henry Langhorst VI. Olivia Monge Nundongo. Jasmine Kamal Newman.
Congratulations to Master's graduates of Framingham State University.
Congratulations, everyone. Please remain seated for just one moment. Just one moment. Please remain seated. We're going to celebrate just so soon. Just one more moment. Congratulations. You are now part of a strong and ever-expanding network of alumni from Framingham State who play a very crucial role in many of the Commonwealth's leading businesses and public sector organizations. We hope you will stay engaged with your alma mater through alumni activities and take advantage of all the alumni benefits available to you. Thank you so much to everyone who's joined us today to celebrate our amazing graduates. Graduates, families, and friends are invited to join us all in a reception and light refreshments over in the McCarthy Dining Annex. We hope you'll join us. Please remain seated until the platform party, faculty, and graduates exit. Thank you so much, and congratulations, everybody. Congratulations.